The polar bears had been up to their nasty tricks again, and the North Pole penguins had had enough. They were off to the South Pole to make their home, where no polar bears could bully them. Penguin Small watched his friends plop into the ocean and swim away.
"Come on,"
they shouted.
"You can do it."
But Penguin Small wouldn't. He couldn't. He was terrified of water. He always had been. Penguin Small watched until his friends disappeared among the bobbing waves. Then he put his head under his wing and cried until the tears made a long icicle on the end of his beak. After a while he wandered off along the water's edge, staring down at his feet and sniffing loudly. He did not see the snowman, which is why he bumped into him.
"You weren't here yesterday,"
said the penguin.
"Did the Eskimos make you?"
"What are Eskimos?"
said the snowman, who had been made only that morning and had not learned many words.
"And what is yesterday?" he said. "And what are those?"
Penguin Small turned round and gave a frightening squeak. The polar bears were coming.
"Let me hide under your hat,"
squeaked Penguin Small.
"What's hat?"
said the snowman. Without answering, Penguin Small hopped onto the snowman's arm, then onto his shoulder, and onto his head. He lifted the hat and crawled underneath. "Shh," he whispered.
"Shush," repeated the snowman loudly.
Penguin Small reached down and rubbed out the snowman's mouth with his flipper. The polar bears were in a terrible mood.
"There are the penguins," said the first.
The snowman said nothing.
"There are the penguins,"
growled the second. The snowman said nothing.
"Tell us where they are,"
roared the third, and he began to thump the snow with his great paws. Still the snowman said nothing. Soon all three bears were jumping up and down in rage. The ice groaned and creaked under them. With a loud crack, the snowman broke away from the shore and floated away on his own little iceberg.
"Serves you right," roared the bears.
They floated out to sea until the North Pole was left far behind. For days the little iceberg drifted south. Penguin Small drew a little mouth for the snowman, and to pass the time he taught him all the words he knew. Each day the sky grew brighter and the air warmer, but the snowman did not melt. He was made of the North Pole snow, and as everyone will tell you, the snow that falls at the North Pole never melts. At last an island appeared on the horizon. The island was a wonderful place.
"It's full of jungly birds," said the snowman, who began to make up words of his own.
They never had seen Threekins before, nor heard hooter crabs, nor made friends with the Neverwasanoceros. The Neverwasanoceros spent his time drawing. For each animal that appeared on the forest, there was a picture on the rocks. There were hundreds of them.
"This jungle land is a wonderful place," said the snowman. "I want to stay here forever."
But Penguin Small began to miss his friends.
"If only I could swim," he said to Neverwasanoceros one day.
"Perhaps you should fly," said the Neverwasanoceros.
"Penguins can't fly," said Penguin Small.
The Neverwasanoceros smiled and went back to his drawing. He said nothing more. The snowman did not want Penguin Small to go, but he gave him his hat for a boat when it was time to say goodbye. A teardrop trickled from his eye and froze on his cheek as he pushed Penguin Small out to sea. Penguin Small floated out on the wide ocean. He did not know where he was, nor where he was going. The sky grew dark, and big drops of rain began to fall. All night long, the storm blew. Penguin Small huddled in the bottom of Snowman's hat, while the wave tossed it high into the air and sent it spinning round and round. Before the storm had passed, Penguin Small found himself washed up on a strange blue island.
"This is a very odd island," he said. "It has no sand, no trees, and no jungly birds of any kind."
But the island was not an island. It was a great big blue. Whoosh! Penguin Small found himself flying through the air, flapping his flippers furiously. The snowman's hat fell into the sea. The scarf fluttered after it, but Penguin Small stayed right where he was, hovering in mid-air, squeaking at the top of his voice, "I can fly! I can fly!" Then suddenly his wings got tired and he dropped like a floppy cushion onto the whale's nose.
"Did you see? Did you see? I was flying!" he panted.
They travelled far to the south. The air became cold and icebergs began to float by. The whale was heading south to cold waters. He was used to travelling the oceans alone, but he was happy for Penguin Small to ride along with him. While the whale swam, Penguin Small practiced his flying, landing on the whale's nose when he needed a rest. As the days passed, he became an expert at diving, soaring, hovering, gliding, whizzing, but never quite managing, try as he might, to loop the loop. One day, climbing high in the sky, Penguin Small spotted land. Looking down, he saw little shapes, just like himself, lined up along the shore.
"Penguins!" he squeaked.
Way below him, the whale launched himself clean out of the water. The whale landed in the sea with a boom like a crack of thunder. Then he slid beneath the waves, flapping goodbyes with his enormous tail. With a whoop of delight, Penguin Small soared into the air, looped the loop almost, and pointed his beak towards home.
Thank you.
there never talked a snowman, nor penguin ever flew, and there never was an osseous to make this rhyme for you.